A lot of people in Southern Maryland are just friendly, good people.
A lot of friends here.
I like the people. A lot of my family lives here.
And everybody loves to come here and visit. And I get to be the tour guide.
So tons of fun stuff for the kids to do. Lots of boating, and it's beautiful out here to be on the water. The schools are great. And so we just love like the small town feel with the amenities of a larger area.
Hi, I'm Rebecca Bridget, the St. Mary's County Administrator. 2019 was a robust year for St. Mary's County as we provided programs and services to the community while adhering to the mission of the Commissioners of St. Mary's County. To be responsible to the county's citizens, provide effective and efficient services, preserve the county's environment, heritage, and rural character, and foster opportunities for future generations.
I'm Lori Jennings Harris, the Director of St. Mary's County Department of Aging and Human Services. Part of the mission and the goal of St. Mary's County Department of Aging and Human Services is to help people maintain their independence. So nurturing young people, families, youth, as they grow into their senior years, we are here to then help them remain active, engaged socially, maintain their nutritional needs, as well as maintain their health. So the new Garvey Senior Activity Center will allow us to have more room for more activities and programs for more people. And there was a group of older adults in St. Mary's County that felt there was a need to move the project along sooner rather than later. So they were huge advocates for doing that. We learned also of an opportunity to apply for a grant for capital improvement. And we were recently notified of its award in the amount of $800,000. We're excited about the kitchen at the new Garvey Senior Activity Center. It will have commercial grade appliances. We'll be able to serve a minimum of 100 people in the dining room. Between the home delivered meals program and the congregate meals program, we provide approximately 250 to 300 meals per day. There was a request for us to consider providing a congregate meals program for the residents of Cedar Lane Senior Living. The commissioners decided to support that request. We are not only providing a nutritious meal to seniors in need who have no other way of getting a meal, but we're also providing social contact, an opportunity for social interaction. In 2019, we successfully rolled out the Keys to Independence program. So we have connected with a local college to provide workshops on a regular basis. And we invite anyone who is interested to come and learn about the services and programs that the Department of Aging and Human Services provides, but not only our department, but other resources in the community. We initiated the first annual centenarian recognition. We had approximately 7 centenarians and their family members, and we celebrated their accomplishments in the community and their family and the importance of their life to not only the family, but their community. The Youth Advisory Commission came about as an idea by Commissioner Morgan. Members of the Youth Advisory Commission are able to advise the commissioners of St. Mary's County about policies and programs that impact the youth of St. Mary's County.
Hello, my name is John Dietrich. I'm Director of Public Works and Transportation for St. Mary's County. I picked this particular location here at Piney Point Museum because it points out a very important piece of work that we have to do in conjunction with Parks and Recreation and several outside agencies. Shoreline erosion has eliminated access to this very important pier, and we have to work together to bring it back. DPW&T is focusing on shoreline resiliency because the county has 550 miles of shoreline when you count all the bays and necks, and that doesn't account for the creeks and all the other smaller bodies of water. So the ability of this county to survive sea level rise and land sinking makes it critical for DPWNT to put together a multi-year plan and fund it so that we can build the projects that are necessary to keep this county from washing into Chesapeake Bay. 2019 was particularly important for the airport. The private sector has been building out multiple new buildings there. So extending the infrastructure, the roadways, runway, the taxiway, creating new aprons for planes to park on, all of those things became especially critical. Private development has really brought St. Mary's County into the 21st century and linked us very strongly to Pax Naval Air Station with technology transfer. There's also the ongoing critical nature of the helicopter service for both the hospital, MedStar, and the State Patrol, who has their helicopter stationed here at St. Mary's County that services all of Southern Maryland. In 2019, we finished a segment of FDR Boulevard, and we're looking forward to opening yet another one first thing next year. It's also going to be, when completed, up through Peg Road, will be an important connector to the base and the gate. The Department of Public Works does this sort of work along with maintaining and building new county buildings, maintaining and building new roadways, stormwater facilities, the drainage ditches outside all your houses, many things that this department does to try to make this county the best county there is.
I am Chris Kaslimas. I'm the Director of Economic Development for St. Mary's County. One of our biggest accomplishments in 2019 is working on the Airport Innovation District. When you hear the term Innovation District, I'd like you to picture a campus-like setting with places where there are mature companies, there are startup companies, there are students learning at institutions of higher education, there's innovation and research and development happening, but there's also places to live, there's residential units, there's an industrial park where manufacturing takes place, there's also retail, people can go and get things that they need, services, also restaurants and bars, and we're working on a master plan to connect all those assets which already exist here and connect them physically and also connect them with a shared vision. So they will attract the younger workforce who like to have one place they can go to. They can maybe get on a bike or walk from one building to another, go get a cup of coffee, meet different people from different walks of life, exchange ideas. That will really spur innovation. Here at the airport, they do aircraft modification. They do a lot of things related to aircraft and aviation. Also, at UAS, we have the University of Maryland UAS test site, which is doing testing and research on unmanned autonomous systems every day. They're breaking new ground. They're the ones who delivered an organ up in Baltimore, the first in the world to transport an organ via a drone, and that was a successful operation. So they're right here. We have our Techport Business Incubator here on this campus. They're helping startup companies in various technology fields to grow into full-size businesses. The other thing we're working on in St. Mary's County is a regional agriculture center. This year we received a $1 million check from the Southern Maryland Agriculture Commission to build a meat processing center. We're going to be looking to open that probably within a year to have all the farmers within this region don't have to go to Virginia to get their meat processed. And people that live here can go to a place right in St. Mary's County and get meat that was grown here in St. Mary's County. The North County Farmers Market is going to have two buildings. One is going to be for fresh produce and flowers and vegetables. The other building is going to be for value-added products such as meats and cheeses. 2019 was a great year for the Economic Development Department. We're working on over 80 projects in many, many different areas to increase and improve the economy of St. Mary's County. The work that we do in the Economic Development Department goes to helping the very large companies and working very closely with the base, which was our largest employer. It's also helping small businesses, mom and pops, and small startups to establish a business here in St. Mary's County. So we touch the realm from the very small to the very large.
I'm Steve Walker. I'm Director of Emergency Services for St. Mary's County. In 2019, Emergency Services has been working on a lot of different projects. Accreditation is national standards that we are going to live by. The purpose of this is to achieve a level of excellence. Along with that is quality assurance. We truly are trying to improve customer service. Who we serve is the person that calls 911, that calls the police, that calls for an ambulance. We're working to develop an animal shelter. We have selected a location on FDR Boulevard down behind Target and Lowe's and a few of the other stores. We are going through the RFP process to find a builder. CAD RMS replacement, the general public might not see that, but that's really critical for the fire, EMS, police. Our CAD computer-aided dispatch is about 25 years old, so we really need to upgrade that. That will be critical and, again, equates to better service for our community. Next-gen 911, many people may have heard that. Right now, if you are at Point Lookout and you dial 911, that phone might ring in Virginia based on the tower locations. Next-gen 911, it will identify your location almost instantaneous. It's about 7 seconds. It will identify you at your location by GPS, global positioning system, through your phone, and then it will go directly to that 911 center. If there is a need to transfer information in the past, you would call, and the new person receiving the call would have to go through all of the questions again. Next-gen 911 will allow us to transfer that instantaneous. There's also going to be a network of all of the 911 centers where we're all connected. One of the most exciting things I'm really happy about is strategic planning. Where do we want to take this department in serving the public? So we've hired a consultant. We're getting ready to do our strategic planning sessions. And once that's done, we'll go back to the commissioners and tell them what we've come up with and then make a plan on how we're going to move forward. Some of that's going to be staffing, some of that's going to be equipment, other needs. But strategic planning is really an exciting thing for me to take us into the future.
I'm Bob Kelly. I'm the Chief Information Officer for St. Mary's County Government. In 2019, the Information Technology Department has gone to great lengths to remove the stovepipes in St. Mary's County Government and make data that's available in individual departments and agencies available across all the agencies and departments and open that information up to the citizens of St. Mary's County. Our most significant enhancement in St. Mary's County Government has been our geographic information systems and improvements to our geographic information systems. This gives the citizens the ability to go online and get virtually all the information that county government has, historical records and current records related to a specific property. Boundary lines, services that are provided in that area, whether it's water, sewer, permits, development, just a whole treasure trove of information that's now readily available to the citizens 24 hours a day, 7 days a week online. We spent significant effort early in the year to update the Lexington Park Development District Master Plan. It has been a collaborative effort, and really it's combining data repositories that each of these individual departments and agencies have, combining them and making available to the decision makers information and data that allows them to make data-driven decisions. This is good for the residents, for current residents that are here today living here, so they can track the status of whatever permits and development that they're trying to do on their properties. And it also helps folks that are considering moving to St. Mary's County and what can possibly be done with property that they might be considering purchasing or relocating here. And it's great for developers, folks that want to develop property and do stuff with the land in St. Mary's County. It's been said that Maryland's open for business, St. Mary's County's open for business. And so we believe, and it's direction from the Board of County Commissioners, that for open and transparent government, we believe that if the most current and relevant information is made available, then the right decisions can be made, and that's what we're trying to do for St. Mary's County.
Hi, I'm Bill Hunt, Director of Land Use and Growth Management in St. Mary's County. In 2019, one of our biggest accomplishments was working out a system with home builders that allowed them to make field changes to add additional impervious surface, such as patios, for instance, and walkways, on approved site plans without having to come back to the office and get their stormwater management plans re-reviewed for compliance with Maryland state law and the St. Mary's County ordinance. For the builder, what this means is saving probably 5 to 10 days of re-review time, which, depending upon where they are in the process, that is how close they are to getting the certificate of use and occupancy, can possibly mean delaying a closing, which is a major inconvenience both for the builder who wants to transfer ownership and, of course, the homeowner who may be waiting to move in. The Maryland Department of the Environment has a detailed guide for what they call environmental site design practices that have to be installed on individual home sites. What this means is that the stormwater is treated on site to the quantity and quality limits that are set by the state, and St. Mary's County enforces as well. Our ability to do these reviews does not diminish the environmental protection. All it does is allows the design professionals to oversize these devices that are required to a certain extent to accept additional runoff should the homeowner decide that they want to add a patio or a walkway or a deck without this re-review process. The biggest behind-the-scenes accomplishment that we had this year involves the Lexington Park Development District zoning maps and zoning text amendments that were recently heard by the commissioners of St. Mary's County at a public hearing. That was a lot of work, a lot of cooperation with various departments to get these things to the finished product that they are. The GIS IT department was intricately involved, as was the county attorney, to be sure that these things are online properly where people can look at them. And also, the zoning regulations that were written specifically for Lexington Park are designed to allow maximum flexibility so that it will encourage development to come to the county's largest and going to be premier development district in the future.
Arthur Shepherd, Director of St. Mary's County Recreation and Parks Department. The Department of Recreation and Parks, and teaming with the county commissioners, I think we've made a great deal of progress, especially in our youth sports area. Putting synthetic turf fields to enhance play and safety for our youth sports, our multi-sport leagues. This will impact our lacrosse, field hockey, rugby, soccer, and football teams throughout the county. And in that project, we have fields slated to be placed at Chaptico Park, Chancellor's Run Regional Park right here, and also at Lancaster Park and Lexington Park. Second, as a destination and tourism places, our staff has come aboard and realized what we mean to a community as far as leisure activities, healthy living, and strengthening families. We've increased 40% of our waterfront parks over last year there, but one of the areas we know now is we have to enhance our parking. We have plans in effect for architect and engineering master plans for Myrtle Point, Elms, Snow Hill, as well as Shannon Farms, which is right off of adjacent to Gate 3. The Lexington Manor Passive Park, if funded in the budget now, is funds to have a street renovation project for a passive park, non-motorized wheels. That means strollers, bicycles, for walking paths and trails, as well as for the arts and other programming. All those things in a safe setting with new public restrooms, lighting, improvements, a safe area that enhances Lexington Park and draws the community together. St. Clement's Island Museum, there's a $1.5 million project there to enhance the facility, parking, as well as the exhibits. Well, this is our Phase 7 of the Three Notch Trail. That picks up at the water tower there. I think most of you are familiar with that, the water tower there in Hollywood. 3.3 miles, we're at 65% design phase. We're looking for construction to begin sometime in the summer of 2020. The commissioner signed a resolution this past spring saying that our parks and museums will be tobacco-free beginning September 1. We know our role in the community and recreation, what it means to have a viable recreation department in any community. So we're going through the accreditation process as we speak. We're developing our vision statement, mission statement, our strategic plan, be bringing it to the Recreation and Parks Advisory Board and the approval of county commissioners so we can continue to move forward and be accredited agency and something that the citizens can be proud of.
On May 21st, 2019, the commissioners signed the approved budget for the St. Mary's County fiscal year 2020, which included a general fund budget of $253 million, which is a 10% increase over fiscal year 2019. the property tax rate remained at 0.8478 per $100 of assessed value. The income tax rate changed to 3.17%. Operating and capital budgets focused on commissioner priorities of public safety, education, and infrastructure. For instance, non-grant funding for the Sheriff's Office increased by 7.2%, including new positions, new vehicles, operating impacts for the Adult Detention and Rehabilitation Center renovations and the Sheriff's Office District 4 station, and funding for promotional ranks. St. Mary's County Public Schools funding increased by 2.3% to $106.2 million, nearly $3 million over the maintenance of effort required calculation. Education is a priority, reflecting 46% of the county non-grant recurring revenue. St. Mary's County departments received new positions, new vehicles, and increased costs for public safety technology upgrades and maintenance. The implementation of a three-year phase-in compensation study began in fiscal year 2020. Residents will also notice commissioner-approved enhancements to the St. Mary's Transit System. Highlights of the $81.7 million capital improvement plan include the approval of the Adult Detention Rehabilitation Center addition, agriculture land preservation, airport improvements, a St. Mary's County animal shelter, asphalt overlay to many roads and parking areas, culvert replacement and drainage improvements to extend the life of many of our roads, the extension of FDR Boulevard, plans for multi-purpose synthetic turf fields, a North County Farmers Market, the Patuxent Park Neighborhood Preservation Project, improvements to the recreational facilities and parks, radio system upgrades for emergency services, the Rural Legacy Program, St. Clement's Island Museum renovations, and $13.5 million for public school projects. The commissioners and county staff maintained incredible focus and attentiveness this year, positioning St. Mary's County for fiscal stability while ensuring the best possible quality of life for our residents.